lesson 011101. Let's begin.
Now concentrate.
Control.
Concentration.
Clarity.
Happy birthday, Array Music. It has been an honor and a privilege to be Array's artistic director for the last few years, and I look forward to the next 50. All right? Okay, ready? Say bye, James.
Bye. We're celebrating 50 years of Array Music, 50 years of creation, of composing, of continuing to explore new directions. And Array's going to keep on doing that, engaging new communities, new sounds, and new ways of being. Thanks for being part of our journey.
Universe and the galaxy are in hyperlight communication across space and time.
Thank you. for coming to the first concert of Array's 50th anniversary sort of festival year. I'm David Chotko, I'm Array's artistic director. Probably most of you know me, and I probably know most of you, but it's really great. This is the most people we've had in the space in about 2 years at one time. It's so nice to see everybody. So it has been really, really special for me to program this season. I feel so extraordinarily lucky to be the artistic director, to be able to program this 50th anniversary. And it's fun, especially because I'm not a composer, I'm a percussionist, you know, so it's been a delight to dig back through the repertoire and find all of this, you know, find all of this music that I wasn't a part of creating, but I wish I had been, you know. So this program highlights really is, there's so much music, first of all. I could have filled 5 more concerts, but it was unfortunately not possible. So this concert sort of represents Array's roughly first 20 years, you know, so things from 1972 to roughly 1992, although Linda Catlin Smith's piece is a much more recent piece, so, you know, I was fudging things here and there from the actual, the actual dates. But it still roughly represents the first 20 years of Array music. Next week, a week from right now, we'll be playing a portrait concert of Michael Baker's music. And that represents sort of a middle, sort of a second 8-year period where Michael was Array's longest running artistic director. And this program, this is a really special program because it was originally planned for the 20th anniversary of his untimely death, but in 2020, and it was one of the first things that had to be postponed during the pandemic. So it seemed very appropriate for it to drop on the 50th anniversary season. And then we're coming back in the spring. There's more stuff, you know, look at the website, but there's more stuff all year. But we're coming back in the spring I'm playing a duo concert with my other artistic director, percussionist predecessor, Rick Sachs, which will be really fun. That's in March. And then April, another 2 weeks in a row, we're doing, the first one is the next 20 years, so roughly 2002 to 2022. And it'll have music by Alison Cameron, who I see back there, and Bob Stevenson and Martin Arnold, and then a couple commissions probably from Michael Osterley and Nicole Lizet. So sort of more recent stuff. And then the last program of the season is really fun. It's our annual 4 New Works concert. We know every year Array commissions 4 new pieces. And kind of delightfully, it's on the 20th of April of 2022, which is the 51st anniversary to the day of the first Array concert [S2] Wow. [S1] In 1972. They played 6 premieres back then. We are only doing 4, but Array's still doing what it's always done. So that concert features a piece by Bruce Russell, who's here, and Sung Wan Oh, commission. Both of those were originally scheduled for during the pandemic as well. And then also new pieces from Rose Bolton and Sheldon Patterson for DJ and the Array Ensemble. So it's gonna be really fun. And it's been really a delight to program this year. Feel incredibly lucky. While I'm up here, I need to thank all of our funders, the Ontario Arts Council, the Canada Council for the Arts, all the foundations, the Toronto Arts Council, pardon, all the foundations that sponsor us. I also am very excited to announce that, and I have to read this one so I get it right, that Array was very lucky to receive a grant from the Trillium Foundation this year through its Community Building Fund. Array Music was able to purchase for us and our community hospital-grade HEPA filters, new cameras and microphones, hard drives, a storage cabinet for all of our microphones and stuff, and a bunch of much-needed equipment to kind of upgrade our live streaming and technical capacity for the space. So a huge thank you to the Trillium Fund and all the other funders that have supported Array over the years. One other very, really, really important announcement I want to make, and well, pitch that I want to make to everybody. Back by the bar is just right by the bar, it's on the bar, is a red donation box. And with the bar is free tonight, it will be for all of the 50th anniversary shows. But please donate please put some money in the box. I'm really begging all of you to do it. Everything that goes in the box will go directly to Stephen Clark, Array's longtime pianist. And many of you probably know Stephen is currently undergoing treatment for fairly advanced cancer and is unable to play with us all season. And so any little bit you can give would really, really be helpful. We'll be giving all year, we'll be giving everything that can go into that box straight to Stephen. So please, please give something. It will help immensely. And that's it for the announcements. Before we move forward, I need to acknowledge that Arraymusic operates on ancient land, a land that has seen and supported humanity for 15,000 years. It's the land of the Patoon First Nations, the Seneca, and most recently the Mississaugas of the Credit First Nation. The land is subject to the Dish With One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant, an agreement between the Haudenosaunee Confederacy and the Anishinaabeg Nation to peaceably share and care for the resources in the Great Lakes region. Toronto remains a meeting place and is still the home to many Indigenous peoples from across Turtle Island. And I think that's all for the speaking.
Well,
and from now on, we'll just play music for you. So thank you once again, all of you, for coming. And I'm very much looking forward to seeing all of you back next week, and in March, and in April, and in May, and all of the stuff we're doing. So thank you very much. So I really appreciate it.
Ha ha ha!
now we do have to move some percussion instruments, so bear with us. Thank you.
I'm sorry, I thought you were just like, yeah, boy.
Thank you. Thank you.
just reminded that I completely forgot to say something about the film that happened at Headquarters. So it's too much going on these days. So that was a film by one of our board members, Lori Klasnick, who has been...
Bravo.
Yeah, right? So she's adopted a whole bunch, temporarily adopted a whole bunch of our sort of hard copy archives, and has been scanning them and making films out of them. So that there's actually, the plans are to have a longer version that we'll be screening, essentially. One of the things that we haven't entirely announced yet is we're doing a little film festival, an Array film festival. It'll be in February. And that will be, you know, the intention is for that to be one of them. And there's a few other things sort of on the burners that we'll let you know about later. But thank you, Lori. It's really great and really fun. And obviously, you know, Rick and Linda and I and everyone was involved in making little happy birthday messages. And Allison was playing the ukulele. All right, and then we'll start again. Thank you. All right. Thank you.
Thank you. I've heard